Hey everyone, and thanks for checking out this video. Today we're in Western Kentucky at the Warrior Coal Mine near Madisonville. I want to send a thank you to photographer Jim Pearson for sharing a picture of this place in a Facebook group. Without him and those pictures, I wouldn't have found either of the mines that I went to. I'll put a link to his photographs in the description for you to check out. And again, Jim, thank you very much. Well, there's already a train in the loading loop, so let's jump right in. The loop here is a teardrop shape that's about a quarter of a mile wide. This is a Paducah and Louisville train that will head to a power plant in Louisville, but I don't know the symbol. I'll be making some comparisons to my previous coal loading video from Princeton, Indiana. So if you haven't checked that out, click here and take a look. We'll focus on the loading operations first and then go into detail about the coal preparation plant. While this is the Warrior Coal Mine, it's owned by the same company, Alliance Resource Partners, as our previous mine. First up, the loading tower here looks to be an open-air hopper, unlike the closed tower that we saw at our previous mine. You can see the empty bottom dump hoppers behind the tower and the filled ones in front. It takes about 90 seconds to fill one of these hoppers, so a little faster than our previous operation. I'm going to let you watch everything as it happens and explain along the way. As usual, the first part will be sped up, and then the real-time footage will be at the end of the video. This view gives us a pretty good look of how everything is laid out and works together. You can barely see the conveyor belt at the top of the screen where the coal is brought to the facility. We'll take a closer look at the bulldozers. The prepared coal is moved through that overhead conveyor belt. It's then dropped in that concrete cylinder where it spills out. Now the bulldozers then push the coal into an underground hopper that loads it onto a conveyor belt that you can see on the right of your screen. The coal then heads up the conveyor belt and is dropped into the loading tower hopper. You can see where that operator is controlling the loading of the coal. For as complex as this system is, it only takes a handful of people to get the loaded coal onto a train once it's been mined. I found this statistic while researching this video. In case you didn't know, coal mining is a very dangerous job. In December of 2023, the workers at this facility celebrated 2,555 days without a lost time injury. That's 7 years of safety. I just wanted to point that out. All right, back to the process. Now we're behind the coal loader, so we get a better view of just how the coal flows into the hoppers. I'm not sure, but I think you can see the water sprayer there. It's next to the yellow painted catwalk. Those are used to keep the coal damp so it doesn't spontaneously combust when it's warm out, and it's to cut down on dust. I went back and looked on the other side, but I didn't see a sprayer there. My guess is this loop can be loaded in either direction. We can see Powell Locomotive 4503, an EMD SD70 Mac, pushing on the end of the train. The locomotives are pushing and pulling the cars through the loading tower at less than half a mile an hour. Here we'll take a closer look at the coaling tower. You can see the coal hopper in the blue that feeds the chute below. This coal is continuously fed into the hopper. I'm not sure if that's dust or maybe steam coming off the coal from being treated to remove impurities. It was pretty cold outside when I shot this. Now let's follow the conveyor belt down. We can see the underground loader from the conveyor belt. That's where the coal the bulldozers are pushing comes out. We'll watch as this train finishes loading and then heads off. Sorry for the shaky camera work you're about to see. While I was parked, several people stopped and talked to me and made sure that I wasn't having car trouble and didn't need any help. They were very friendly here. As the train heads out of sight, here's a closer look at the switch for the loop. Just a regular hand-thrown switch. Well, let's follow along for a little bit as our train heads east. As we catch up with the front end, we see a former Union Pacific locomotive. I believe this is an SD-70M. The leader is 4518, another SD-70 Mac. As we turn around and head back, take a look at that massive hill in front of us. I'm not 100% positive, but I believe this is the coal refuse pile. While I was filming, I saw a steady flow of loaded, massive dump trucks head to this area and then return empty a few minutes later. Like I mentioned, coal's not ready to be used right out of the ground. It needs to be cleaned of any impurities. This pile, I believe, is the waste product. A closer look at the top of the hill shows more conveyor belts. I didn't see it, but my guess is those dump trucks unload at the bottom of the hill, and then the waste is carried up here and then spread out on top of the mound, and it just keeps growing. For every metric ton of coal produced, about 880 pounds or 400 kilograms of waste material remains. This is not the same as what's left when coal is burned at a power plant, though. All right, well, back to the mine. This facility you're looking at is where the coal is brought out of the ground. It's a little less than half a mile north of the loading area. Like the first mine, this is a room and pillar mining operation. Here's a closer look at where it comes out. You can see the concrete tube where the coal is brought to the surface. The raw coal is loaded onto the conveyor belt and then carried to the processing facility. That pile in front of us is where the raw coal is dropped. The bulldozers then push to an underground loader where the next conveyor belt will start its journey to the coal preparation plant, or CPP. It's tough to tell, but you can see these pieces are of all shapes and sizes, and they don't have that uniform black coal color. Here we get a look at the coal as it's being fed by the conveyor belt. You can see it spilling out of the opening below. As we continue to watch, here's a little more on how the coal is processed. I believe the white building on the right side of your screen is where the coal preparation plant is. That's where the run-of-mine coal is washed. Straight out of the ground, there's dirt and other impurities that need to be removed. Gravity is used to separate the coal from heavier rocks. The coal is then fed into a cone-like structure where it's further refined. Now, once it's been separated and cleaned, the coal then heads to a dryer where any remaining water is removed. From there, it's ready to be transported to a power plant or another processing plant. Well, that's the end of our journey for today. I hope you liked this video, and if you haven't already, check out some of my other videos on coal. If you really enjoyed this video, I would certainly appreciate you hitting that like button. It really does help. I've got a few rail yard videos in the works, but I'm always looking for other places to record. So if you know of anywhere, please do let me know. Until our next trip, I hope you have a great day.
I'm gonna get the brake, guys. flight. I pulled full service on it. in the rack, Jock. He said there's one here in the fire siding on that train. But good Lord, you know what I mean? second crew room, or the locker room, storage room up there where the water is.
Got you loaded.